Most guys think that testosterone will shut down your fertility. But what if I told you that you could naturally increase your testosterone levels while also preserving your fertility? I'm Dr. Justin Houman, board certified urologist and men's health specialist, and I see over 30 guys a day with this same question. How do they boost their testosterone levels naturally while preserving their fertility? Today, we're gonna talk about enclomiphene, its benefits, why it's better than testosterone replacement therapy, and how it differs from clomiphene. Before we do, feel free to click the like button and subscribe so we can continue bringing this men's health content. What is enclomiphene? The better way of answering that question is to figure out what is clomiphene. So clomiphene is a combination of two chemicals. One of them is enclomiphene and the other one is zuclomiphene. Enclomiphene is involved in increasing your luteinizing hormone or your LH, your follicle stimulating hormone or your FSH, and both of these increase your testosterone production as well as your sperm production. Zuclomiphene is more of a weak estrogen, and what that does is it kind of competes with the testosterone in terms of acting on the receptor. So think of enclomiphene as being the gas, zuclomiphene being the brakes. So enclomiphene is the trans isomer of clomiphene. Historically, we've prescribed clomiphene to men if they're having fertility issues or specifically if they're having hypogonadism or low testosterone levels. We use it off-label for men to increase their testosterone levels. Now we have the ability of separating enclomiphene from the clomiphene combination. And enclomiphene, as I mentioned, is just the gas portion of this. So what it does is it's a pure, cleaner version. And by doing so, you could get all the benefits of clomiphene without any of the side effects of the zuclomiphene compound. What's the data show? So men using enclomiphene, we have data to support that it increases your testosterone levels anywhere from 150 to 200 points at least. And the beautiful thing about it is it doesn't raise your estrogen levels the same way clomiphene does. Because it's cleaner and it doesn't necessarily act as a weak estrogen, it could stabilize or it keeps your estrogen levels at a stable level versus clomiphene, which can increase your estrogen levels. And by doing so, it competes with the testosterone at the receptor. So you may not necessarily feel the impact of a higher testosterone level with the clomiphene, but you will when you're on enclomiphene. And that's the reason why guys are asking for it more these days, because it can help support a higher testosterone levels without the negative effects of the estrogen at the receptor level. What's the typical dosage of enclomiphene? We usually say anywhere from 12.5 milligrams to 25 milligrams, either every other day or on a daily basis. I myself, I prefer to give it at 25 milligrams every other day. The reason being behind this is when you're taking it every day, you don't necessarily develop a sensitivity to it, or you won't develop a sensitivity. It decreases the chances of it. If you take it daily, there's a chance that the receptors get sensitized to this and you won't necessarily feel the impact of it the same way you would if you did it on an every other day basis. So 25 milligrams every other day is generally what I recommend. We always want to make sure you're responding well to it. Number one, symptomatically. Number two, from a blood level standpoint. We always want to make sure your testosterone levels look good. We want to make sure estrogen levels are responding as well. We want to make sure your follicle stimulating hormone, your luteinizing hormone, your prolactin levels, all of these are normal. All of these are responding well to the enclomiphene, just to make sure there's no other changes that we have to make. And the most important thing when it comes to taking enclomiphene is you want to do this in combination with everything that's helpful in terms of maintaining healthy testosterone levels in your body. What does that mean? Exercise right. So enclomiphene will give you better energy levels. So you want to use that to start exercising better. Lifting heavy weights, cardio on a weekly basis. This helps maintain healthy testosterone levels. You want to start eating a healthier diet of lean proteins, complex carbohydrates, and healthy fats. That will help optimize hormone levels as well. Sleep is going to be the biggest one in this. You want to start getting at least 7 to 8 hours of sleep, not just for the hormonal benefits, not just for the stress reduction, for the mental health benefits. All of these will help, again, maintain healthy testosterone levels while your levels are elevated on the enclomiphene. And for myself, the way I like to recommend is guys stay on this for anywhere from 6 to 9 months. They start doing those things that help maintain healthy testosterone levels. And then what we do is we come off the enclomiphene and your levels will be able to stay up there as long as you're doing those eating right, exercising, getting good sleep and reducing your stress levels. You're able to maintain your healthy testosterone levels at that point. So when you have healthy testosterone levels, you're going to have more energy throughout the course of the day. You're not going to feel fatigued. You're going to be able to get another 20-30 minutes at the gym. You're going to be able to wake up with the vigor, with the tenacity to start your day, to commence your day. You're probably going to have to decrease the amount of caffeine intake throughout the course of the day. All of these things give you the more energy, or enclomiphene gives you more energy to do all of those things. It could help with your sexual function, your erectile function, even your libido. Most guys are able to see a change anywhere from 4 to 6 weeks after they start taking it. So when you take it every other day, within 4 to 6 weeks, you should feel something different. And a lot of guys ask, what are the side effects associated with it? So because it's the cleaner version of the clomiphene compound, many men don't really experience side effects. So with clomiphene, the main side effect with it is some guys will get headaches, but a lot of guys will get an increase in estrogen levels, and that plays out by having some nipple tenderness or breast tenderness. But because enclomiphene does not raise your estrogen levels, because it's not a weak estrogen, it helps maintain steady estrogen levels, so you're not getting those side effects associated with clomiphene. The one thing that you have to remember with enclomiphene, at least these days, is it has to be compounded. So because it has to be compounded, you have to go to specific doctors as well as specific pharmacies in order to get it. The reason I like enclomiphene is because it resets the hypothalamus pituitary testicle axis. Anytime there's an issue with getting the hypothalamus to trigger gonadotropin releasing hormone, as well as LH and FSH, what enclomiphene does is it resets the system, and it resets your body's natural ability to produce natural testosterone levels. Rather than TRT, it overrides that system. This helps reset the system. And again, we put you guys on this for anywhere from 6 to 9 months. The system is reset, we take them off, and they're able to go along their way without being on enclomiphene anymore. So that's the main benefit of it to me. Many times, guys are given testosterone replacement therapy when they're interested in fertility, but enclomiphene is able to provide the benefits of testosterone replacement therapy to that subgroup of men who are still interested in fertility, but it doesn't come at the cost of eliminating their fertility potential or decreasing their fertility potential. So it's a wonderful weapon that we have as men's health urologists that could provide men the benefits of boosting their testosterone while also preserving their fertility. If you want more info on how guys are wrecking their testosterone levels, click here.